Sierra Leone is at the crossroad. We are at a time when we need to lay emphasis on the things that we have to lay emphasis on if this country has to survive. When you hear my brother from Audit Service say that 70% of government budget is spent on procurement activities, that is telling you that there is somewhere which risk is concentrated. And that risk is what we call corruption risk. If we do not follow it up with proper processes and procedures, if we do not follow it up with proper supervision mechanisms, if the rules of the game of procurement, which have been outlined and will continue to be outlined by the gentlemen who have spoken to you, are not recognized. Procurement itself has various stages, several stages. And those stages, of course, the gentleman from the World Bank has outlined. I don't have to go over them again. But each of those stages have corruption risk. That means there is a concentration of decision making and sometimes monopoly. And once these two are combined, we have a situation whereby it is likely to lead to people doing what we call in economic terms rent-seeking, profiteering. Their own interests will supersede the general interest, and that is what we have to avoid. So at the Anti-Corruption Commission, the fight against corruption is centered on four pillars. Pillar one is prevention. Pillar two is investigation. Pillar three is prosecution. Pillar four is public education. Issues of procurement lie in the prevention aspect of the fight against corruption. You see, most times what you all and all of us, what we appreciate about the fight against corruption, the thrills that we have about the fight against corruption, are concentrated in pillar two, investigation and prosecution. We want to see people arrested and prosecuted and say, yes, that is no sacred cow. We want to hear that many people have been convicted. In fact, we want the anti-corruption to deploy more scorpion squads, arresting people, running after them in a militarized fashion. That is what we often regard as a strong anti-corruption fight. But let me disappoint you to say it is the weakest anti-corruption fight. An anti-corruption fight that is predicated on militarized anti-corruption efforts is weak. A strong anti-corruption effort is prevention, where you deploy tools within the economy, within the system, to ensure that the opportunities and incentives of corruption do not fester, they do not survive, they do not overtake everything. And procurement is a very important aspect of that. In my topic, I have said implementing e-procurement in Sierra Leone, applying the sterilization pill to the mother of most corruption in Sierra Leone. The reason why I use that allegory is to capture your minds, to understand that this area where you are all coming in the various universities, but particularly in IPAM, that is the area that is causing more corruption in Sierra Leone than any other area. Yes. When he says 70% of government spending is on procurement efforts, I can simply tell you that 70% of corruption is from procurement. There is hardly any case that you deal with in public institutions where the foundation of the corruption that underlies that case is not from procurement. Contracts are a very lucrative path. In fact, if you all remember, in recent times, there was a battle which we fought, and I called it the Battle of the Soul of Sierra Leone. And it was a battle over contracts. When I became commissioner, armed with this knowledge that it is contracts that is the job, you know. If you solve the problem of contracts in Sierra Leone, trust me, most people will not even want to become public servants. Because it will no longer be creative. So, I came up with a very revolutionary bill. Put it to Parliament and said, we want to be there. We have to take steps, because what you do not know is that even though there are rules which say the public procurement can do their work, they can investigate, they can inform the public, they can go there and say this contract is not good, do not go ahead with it. For the longest of time, the people at public procurement will write and communicate to say do not proceed with this contract, and the public servants will say, what is wrong with you? They will proceed and sign anyway. Because the brown envelopes would have passed. Because a lot of bribery would have underlined. From the procurement committees in the public offices to the decision makers in public offices, they share thousands of dollars among themselves. Because as you rightly said, the volume that is involved, contracts worth $1 million, contracts worth $2 million, $3 million. What will it cost a businessman to take $100,000 and give it to a few people to share among themselves? That is why procurement is lucrative. So, I had a conversation with my brother. People said that the ACC wanted to come in to take power away from the NPPA. And I remember calling him on the phone to say, look, this is not about power. This is the jugular. You are doing a lot of hard work. I have seen the letters you sent to ministries. I have seen the letters you sent to departments. But most times, they do not even take you seriously. But we in the Anti-Corruption Commission have the powers. We have the powers. We have powers that have been given to us to strike. So we need to partner to deal with the issues of contract for the good of the country, so that going forward, the story of this country can change. We have bridges that are not bridges. They are collapsing and killing people. It is because of procurement. Because when you have to give contracts to your brothers and sisters, you do not care whether they have the capacity and quality to deliver. We have people everywhere doing business with themselves. Yes, they set up businesses. They are the procurement officers, and they make sure those businesses go through and succeed with the procurement efforts, so that a contract that is worth $500,000, you can use $50,000 to implement. Then you have $450,000 to build houses and live ever happily after. So a bridge that is supposed to be worth $450,000 is worth $50,000. What do you expect? It will have low quality cement, more of sand to collapse. Houses will collapse. Government buildings will be cracking. Contracts to deliver school materials would never happen. And that is all as a result of procurement problems. So, we put a bill before Parliament to say, we, working with NPPA, can now intervene to say this contract is not in the interest of Sierra Leone. Do not proceed. And if you proceed to sign it, you can be arrested and tried summarily, and your punishment is 5 years in prison. And everybody started jumping. All hell got loose. Everybody said that we are seeking power. We wanted to take over the authority of the NPPA. The Ministry of Finance was writing letters. You cannot come here. What is your business? And so the General's Department was the only department that said, go ahead. And I was able to convince my brother and his team. We had several meetings on the issue, and they all saw where we were coming from. That bill took 8 months in Parliament. Because the people who were involved, the people who have held this country to ransom for years, could see that there was something coming for them. If we follow through with what the spirit and intent of that bill is about. We went to parliament, they ambushed us in parliament. When I say ambush, it was a serious ambush. We will go to meetings, committee meetings, it will never end. People will be coming from all over saying this particular session. In fact, I remember the last day in the well of parliament, after we had now agreed on the wording of the provision and everything, when we went to parliament. Parliamentarians that we have respect for, who understand the issues, we are the ones who we are leading the charge to say, everything else in that bill can pass, but this one you have to improve it. But you see, this country has suffered. We are the paradox of the world. We have what it takes to be the shining light in Africa. Not because of anything we can do ourselves, because God blessed the country when it made it. But then, we the people have become our own problem. We attack everything that is good. We undermine processes and systems like procurement rules and regulations. We want the country to remain as it is. So, as it will have it, when we went to parliament, that provision, in fact, the parliamentarian said, you have to remove that provision and we vote on it separately before we even vote on the bill. Because they wanted to kill and defeat it and take it out. As God would have it, they could not succeed. And the bill was passed. And there has been a renewed synergy between us and the ACC and the team at the NPPA for us to make sure that we work together so that procurement succeeds, and that procurement success is a reduction of 70% of the risk in the fight against corruption in Sierra Leone. I want us all to clap for Sierra Leone for that achievement. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, as part of that is why the introduction of e-procurement is very important and significant to everything we are doing. As you know, there are many benefits of e-procurement. Again, I don't want to become too technical. I don't want to go into these things because the gentlemen here are ready to do it. But I will go through them. E-procurement will bring about improved cost for government purchasing. It will increase value for money, which the gentleman from Audit Service made sufficient reference to. I don't have to dilate on it. It will reduce corruption. I have already told you that the concentration of corruption in Sierra Leone is in procurement. You solve procurement problem, you reduce corruption by half in Sierra Leone. So e-procurement, which is a preventive measure, will make sure that the rooms that are there to manipulate the system will be reduced, because there will be little human-to-human interaction. There will be little influence over the process. Of course, it will lead to increased trust in government, because when governments put in place e-procurement, in fact, when there was the Paris Convention for debt relief for Africa, one of the things they said is that when institutions come to Africa, they should rely on the procurement systems in those countries. So, for other countries to have confidence in the procurement system in the country, the mere mention of e-procurement, which they are already very familiar with and they understand the reduction it will bring to the fight against corruption and for corruption risk and mitigation, of course, it will lead to some benefits. It will improve growth and it will increase tax compliance. Because, of course, as we all know, before you can engage in procurement, you have to be registered, you have to go through certain formalities, and when you are registered and captured within the system, you are likely to pay more taxes. So, we at the Anti-Corruption Commission welcome very much this initiative. We believe this is a good thing. It will help the synergy between us and the NPPA. We are working together. Our understanding, which we have signed, is that MOU is that if he sees anything wrong with the system, he does not have to wait. We are not going to run an fire brigade kind of fighting corruption. He can raise the red flag and remove him immediately. That is the synergy we have, and the relationship is very good, and we are working on it. So, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, students, as I conclude, in bringing to you the anti-corruption as perspective to procurement issues and how we welcome e-procurement, let me end by exhorting you to understand that we are at war. You are coming in to that war. It is better for you to advise yourselves now. There's a lot at stake. You are all young, you have a long way to go. Even corruption allegation is capable of damaging you for life. Because the kind of work you do, you are what we call in the sciences fiduciaries. It is trust-based. You are trustees. When somebody is a trustee, the reputation that hangs on that person is everything for that person. So if you are a procurement officer and the industry thinks that you are a corrupt procurement officer, trust me, you will not go far. Our brother here is CEO, chief executive of the NPPA today, because that reputation was not attached to him. We all have a long way to go. If you think that you can beat the system, you are coming to meet e-procurement. I can assure you, e-procurement is a trap. It's a serious trap. It has audit trails. And any system that has audit trails is a dangerous trap. You can do it for 1 year, 2 years, you think you are comfortable, nobody is going to know. Someday, somebody is going to pick it up, and that will be your end. So I am admonishing all of you. We used to be at 49% in the fight against corruption. Today, we sit comfortably at 79%. Whilst you are clapping, let me tell you, please do not take us back to 49%. Because there are laws, and those laws are going to be enforced. We are going to change the story of Sierra Leone. We are going to launder the image of the country, and we are going to succeed as a country. And that is only possible with you, you, and you. I thank you.